making a change today. The liquor been taking the pain away. I heard you was giving your chain away. That's kinda like giving your fame away. What's wrong with you? I sit in a box where the owners do. A boss is a road that I've grown into. I love you to death, but I told you the truth. I can't just be with you, I'm only you.
Yeah. Hey, this is Sasha David, Exonda, and Hi. I'm gonna start highly on. Hey, how's everyone doing? Today on it's like sunny day. I'm gonna like starting like after this chorus, and then I'll turn the music down just to give like people enough time to kind of get in. I spent the live to like some of the people that kind of like responded, so I'm just gonna wait till 10 past and then hey Leon, hey what's up Michael, hi hello. So yeah, I'm just gonna wait till like I think only 2 minutes, yeah 1 minute now, and then I'll turn the music off. Okay. Yeah, how's everyone doing? Has everyone listened to Drake's new album? It's only got 3 songs on it, but you know what, I have to stay lit. I have to say I think I might choreograph to this next. I'm not gonna save this live, by the way. I'm gonna like ask people if they want me to do a video on it, and I'll just put that on my YouTube if the information was helpful. This live will only be about like 15 minutes ish, and then yeah, I'm just gonna wrap it up. Yeah, because I want to give it like a not a fun way. How do I say it? Like, I want it to be easy for people to understand the language, because it just took me so long to understand. So now it's taking me 3 months to understand it all. I'm like, now I can explain it in simpler terms so people just don't feel left in the dark type of thing. But yeah, cool. Okay, so right. Welcome to Inheritance Tax Live. So obviously, as everyone knows, my mum passed away in October, so that was the reason why I had to deal with her estate and her affairs, etc. There's two things that happens when people die. You either write a will or you don't. I'm not going to talk too much about my personal circumstances, but I'm just going to try to give you general information. If you don't write a will, it gets a bit complicated because there's no executors of the estate. So when it comes to who's left over, it would go to the descendants of the deceased if they had children, if they had brothers or sisters, or if their parents are still alive. If the person who died was married, then you get a bit more money to your bandwidth, your allowance, or if they weren't, then you don't. When somebody dies, obviously the first thing that you do, there's a service you can call called Tell Us Once, and they kind of call all the companies, well not all of them, they say they call all of them, but they call like the passport, the national insurance, the DWP for Department of Work and Pensions, and then they call like, if you have a driver's license, they also let DVLA know. But that's kind of about it, like they don't let all the other companies know. In terms of the actual inheritance tax is made up of basically everything that you own. So your house, your car, your life insurance policies, like anything you own in your house over the value of £1,500. So yeah, basically everything. Like, there's not much you can't get away with, and that's the reason why I've given you knowledge, wink wink, so you can do what you need to do to make sure you pay as little tax as possible type of thing. So basically, there's this form you have to fill out called the IHT 400, which basically is it's a form filled up of many forms that you basically have schedules inside the form, then that kind of calculates the amount of tax you're going to pay. In terms of what your bandwidth allowance is, you are allowed, just generally because you live on this earth, you are allowed £325,000, and that is kind of like your starting point, and like anything over that, you must pay tax. So you must pay 40% tax on anything you own over £325,000. To be honest, majority of the people in this lifetime, if you have a house, is you already have that money. Do you know what I mean? So that £325,000, if your house is valued at more than £325,000, you will just be paying tax by default. So then the next part is the resident nil rate band. So that is the nil rate band of £325,000. Then you have the residence nil rate band, which is basically a little cap that they give you on top of it because of the house that you own. So in like, as you can see in the title, nil rate band, and you've got residence. So that's basically about the house. So they give you an extra, I think you have to kind of fill out a survey. I just want to also say that I'm not professional, so if you do want professional advice, definitely call someone, but that's just of my own personal experience. Basically, you get another £175,000 with the residence nil rate band, which is a different schedule on the form. So there's like, in the form, there's about, I think, 15 to 20 schedules, and each schedule is like 3 to 4 pages, which is basically asking about your assets, etc. Which I'm gonna go through like how many schedules there are, obviously not in too much detail, but just lightly, so you kind of know what they're looking to see on the tax account. If the person is married, then you can transfer. There's another part which is like IHT 436. IHT 436 is about the inheritance tax for the house, and the IHT 435 I think is about the spouse. So basically, if the person is married, you get an extra £175,000. So basically, if you're not married, your cap is 500,000. If you fill out a form that basically states that you're one of the living descendants of the deceased person that died. If you don't fill out that form, they're just going to give you the 325,000, and then anything after that, you pay 40% on. The only reason why you would pay 40%, you would pay 36%, is because you would give some of your money in charity. So if you give charitable money or in trust, so you gift it, that's the reason why you pay less tax. In essence, make a will, okay? Like, even if you don't have like big family, big house or whatever, it just means there's less arguments and less confusion after. And when you're calling these other companies, you're already the executor, or the executor's stated in the will. Otherwise, you have to go through the process of proving who you are, giving them like the person who died's like national insurance, their passport, their UTR number, and a lot of information to basically prove that you are who you say you are to the person. One thing I'd also recommend, life insurance. If you don't have life insurance, get life insurance, because it just makes it so much easier. One, when you pass away, if you have any debts, anything you owe outwards, for the people that are still alive to be able to pay on your behalf, because the bill doesn't disappear. Like, it just goes to the next person in line. So if you have like loads of gas bills, electric bills, loans, car insurance, houses, watches, property overseas, like, the person that's still alive is going to have to pay for that. So I would suggest write a will. The reason why this process costs £3,000 is because basically you're gonna send over all the accounts, all the information to the solicitor. They then go through all the schedules and then fill in the relevant information. The reason why it's £3,000 is because they charge you for your emotional stress. So nobody wants to go through, oh, let me fill out all of this deceased rubbish, when the person's died and you're mourning, you want to cry. And that's really what you're paying for, because anyone can do this process. There is a whole IHT 400 notes, which is about, I don't know, 200 pages long, that does help you through. But then there is certain points where you're going to maybe just be a bit confused. So now I'm just going to get into the nitty gritty of what is actually in the account, so you kind of know like what you have to be declaring. And if you try and make sure you pay the little tax as possible, maybe gift your assets to someone you know or love within 7 years before you die, because once you've gifted those things to people, the government can't really take them because they're already in the will to be gifted, which is the reason why the will is so important. Because once you've written down black and white what of your assets is going where, then the person receives it. But if there's no will, it kind of just goes, well, you owe this money, that money. So in terms of what goes in the inheritance tax account, they would ask you if you want to transfer your unused residence nil rate band, which is basically the residence nil rate band from the house that you would have had if the person had a partner, because you still have that residence nil rate band, which what I stated before, which is £175,000. Then you've got your transfer of your unused nil rate band, which is basically the person who you would marry to, who would still be alive, and you can use some of their nil rate bands, which you can transfer over when you get married. If you do not get married, you don't get this benefit of £175,000 extra. So if you're trying to keep that generational wealth, get married, okay? Then the next thing that they ask for is the gifts and other transfers of value. So basically, like I stated before, you gift whatever your assets are 7 years before you die. If you don't do it up to 7 years before you die, void, doesn't count. So you can gift it now. Like, say if I was to gift it now and I died when I was 75, what I wrote is kind of void, because it's not 7 years before I die. The next part that they talk about is jointly owned assets. So if your partner or you, your partner, if you, the person who's died, jointly owned any assets with anybody else, like businesses, cars, houses, land, etc. They then go into the next part, which is land, which is houses, land, buildings and interest in land. So that might be land that you own here, but like might have plenty houses, more than 3, 5, 10, 15. So that's asking you about which houses they are, whether they're freehold, whether they're leasehold, if they're vacant, whether they're people are staying in there, how many properties, and they ask you the value of the property. They do ask you to value the property and get a professional person to value it, which at the moment is great for you. If the person just died, take that stress analysis, because the estate agent will give you a shitty like, oh, the house is only worth this, because they want you to sell really quickly, which is kind of what you need because you want to pay the least amount of tax. So the next part is about the banks and building society accounts. So basically they ask you about all the bank accounts you own, like everything, single bank account, like what's in there, but they're only asking about the date of the death. So if there's money that's gone in there afterwards, don't talk about it. Just saying, trying to save money. And then you've got household personal goods. The household personal goods is basically anything in your house that's over £1,500. By your own discretion. But generally, if you've got like diamonds, chandeliers, you know, antique furniture, and you know, I don't know, antique collection, like, I mean, maybe declare majority of it, because if they decide to kind of deeply analyze the assessment of the account, if they don't believe you, they'll just ask for detail for everything, and then you might have to spiel out more information than you wanted to. So I would always suggest to give as much information as you can, so they don't come back to, hi, could you just give more information, because you've already given enough. Next part is household and personal goods donated to charity. Like I said, if you donate some of your stuff to charity, then you kind of pay less tax, that's 36%, but they ask you to kind of put it in a schedule, like what you gave away. Then it's your pension, so whatever pension schemes that you had with while you're working life, they ask you to kind of fill that out, that's a different schedule. Then they've got life assurance and annuities. So if you've got life assurance, if you've got annuity policies, if you had life insurance on behalf of somebody else, they ask about that as well. Is it just your life insurance policies? Did you pay for your children's life insurance policy, or is it just you? They want all the details. The next thing they ask for about stocks and shares. So if you have stocks and shares, if you're into trading, if you're into Bitcoin, cryptocurrency, any of that, they want to know. So that's listed. Then they've got unlisted stocks and shares and control holdings, including AIM, OFX, and any control holdings of listing shares. I'm not going to act like I know what that is about, because I don't. So I'm just going to leave that one down to you. If you know about it, they want that too. Business relief, business and partnerships, interest and assets. So I'm assuming if you claim for business relief, if you deducted business relief, if you have a partnership, if you have interest and assets, they also want to know about that. Then they've got farms, farmhouses and farmland. So if you own any farms, any lands, they want to know about that. I know it's really long, but I always want to know about everything. Then they've got interest in another estate. So if you have... if the person was entitled to any parts of someone else's estate because someone else died and they was meant to inherit that themselves before they died, or they died now. Debts due to the estate, any money that they owe outwards because they didn't pay anything. So say they had gas bills, electricity bills, water bills, council tax, arrears on the house, rent arrears, whatever bills. Foreign assets, if you own anything like overseas, like in a different country, if you own your house in a different country, land in a different country, business in a different country, property in a different country, different country. Okay. Then they want assets held in trust. So like I said about gifting, like if anyone watched the Meghan interview like yesterday or whatever, like, the assets held in trust. So basically, if you like from the royal family, like they get paid like as servants of society. So even though they get billions, like they don't physically see the money, is like their money goes into a trust for them and they take the money out of the trust. So how they would kind of operate is what you'd be reporting if you was like a royal or you was a prince from a different country, and you just literally put your stuff in a trust. Oh shit. And then it asks about debts owned the risk by this if deceased. So if the person had like took out a crazy loan and they haven't finished paying it off, like tell them about it. That is kind of a help because they kind of deduct that from the money you owe in tax. So if you owe money like for the funeral costs and everything, they take that, the mortgage, the funeral, they take that off before they add up the money that you owe. So they don't just go, yeah, I know, you know, you owe like 70k in mortgage, but it's fine, don't worry about it, you still gotta pay. They kind of do take it off, which is detailed in the schedule. The last part is the National Heritage Assets. Not gonna act like I know about that, because I don't. I'll read you the little section where it says underneath, is any asset already exempt or is exemption now being claimed on the grounds of national, scientific, historic, artistic, scenic or architectural interest? Or does any such asset benefit from an approved maintenance fund or the upkeep and preservation or national heritage assets? So yeah, that's kind of like the detailed part of what they want you to kind of provide in your accounts. This may not be relevant to any of you, but even if you literally just have a car and a house, they want to know. And like I said, your cap is normally 500,000. If you'd have a sibling and they were married, maybe 650,000. But most people, once you have a house, that is kind of your assets. Do you know what I mean? Like, that's it now, you're gonna have to pay. So yes, I really do hope this is kind of interesting and kind of helpful to an extent. I do genuinely think that people should buy insurance, because that will help people that are living behind, leaving behind, being left behind, be able to afford any bills that will be coming their way. I would definitely suggest that you take the stress amount that the estate agent gives you when you go to value any property that you may own. Because that will be the lowest value that they possibly can get you, because they want you to get it out in the market, which will help you if you by paying less tax. Because I'm pretty sure if you revalue the house after, I don't know, 6 to 8 months after the person's died, the price is going to go like up by at least maybe 100,000. So you want to keep that shmoney down, you know, because 40% is a lot of money. Like, end of the day, also as well, your grave, by the way, when you die, like, that grave, you only pay for 99 years. And then after that, like, the rest of the society kind of pays for that graveside. Do you know what I mean? So I just think that it's important to know these things, because no one teaches these things in school. Like, my mum and dad never taught me about these things, because they just didn't. And normally, I don't know about all cultures, but black people in general, black cultures, like Caribbean, African, they will have, like, assets and things for their parents. From their parents, and they won't know. So for instance, like, your mum might have a life insurance policy for you, a house for you, assets for you, but you don't know that you have these assets. So when you get told, right, when she's dead now, you get all these things, no one's told you how to handle it, how to deal with it, how to look after it, because you never knew your whole life, because your mum and dad never told you. They were just like, oh, you never know what you have, you're grateful, you're blessed, you never know, and that's it. But you don't actually find out, like, how. So this is just a little bit of the how. Because if you find out more information about the how, when it comes to asking, if you put the wrong shit down on the IHT form, once it's sent off. You can obviously spend £3,000 with a solicitor to kind of do it. But then they will know an in-depth account of the person who died. And you might still not have a clue the things that they own. And then you're going to have to pay them more money to explain in legal time. Like, I think solicitors are about £200-300 an hour. So you're going to have more time for them to explain to you the breakdown of what it is the person actually owns. I'm like, babe, you just did the account for me, tell me. But they're like, oh no, we £300 an hour. Do you get it? And I'm like, no, why am I paying £300 an hour when I've already paid you £3,000? So to save yourself some time, actually dig in deep and find out what is in there, because you'd probably be surprised. And also, I've kind of found out that during the process of me calling up black people to say, oh, my mum's died, I'm just closing the account, you get a lot of refunds, a lot of discounts, a lot of things taken off, the bill just gets sometimes cleared. Whereas if the solicitor deals with it, they just give you a bill at the end and just say, this is what you owe. There is no lie or whatever, or, do you know what I mean? Like, you're grieving, use a bit of your emotion, talk to them about your situation and say, yeah, well, you know. And then maybe that bill that was £800 is just now £2.50. Just saying. I'm speaking from real shit here. Like, I did manage to get some bills that were crazy, just down to nothing. Just because I was speaking to them. Not because I was like, oh, can you take the bill down? I never said, can you take the bill down? I literally just spoke to them and that was it. So that's why I suggest that you don't cut corners, dig in the deep end and find out what the person owes, etc., etc. I'm gonna just stop now and scroll up and just see if there's any questions. No questions. If there's any questions, feel free to go for it. Now I'm gonna jump off in about 3 minutes. Yeah, I hope this was, like, somewhat helpful for you. If you have any questions, please post it, and I will probably do a video on this when I've done the second part, because the first part of it is the IHC 400, which has like, I don't know, 20 schedules in it. The second part is like the probate bit, which is like a grant of probate. There's also a grant of probate, letters of administration or executors of the will. So when you're executors of the will, that's normally the solicitor, but you can still be the executor of the person who died, but you have to go through the IHT 400 process for them to grant you the letters of administration that tells you then you are now the executor of the estate. And then you get through to the grant of probate, which is the next step, which then all the funds that was allowed for the deceased will be released to you. So yeah, it's just, I think it's just like a black thing, a black space. No one talks about it until you die, and because it's like, oh, it's death and nobody wants, what's a schedule? A schedule is like basically inside a form. You've got like, if you had part one, part A, part two, part three, that would be inside. So it'd be question 29, and question 29A would be the schedule. The schedule would look like tick boxes and stuff like this. So it would look like you put down a form, and inside the form they go, okay, this is the form, because inside the form there's like 16 pages, but the first two forms are schedules. So inside those schedules, you have to print off more forms and fill out those forms, and that's what the schedule is. They call it schedule, but it's basically another form that breaks down the form as well. Like, they just want you to basically, they ask you the same question like 15 times so they know you're not lying, but they ask you in a different way. Like, I'm pretty sure when you heard me reading, it was like, didn't you just say that? Yeah, I did, but they just said it in a different way so they catch you out. Because if they don't say, oh, does they pay life insurance policies on behalf of somebody else? They'd be like, yeah, I pay life insurance policies, and you, but you didn't ask about anybody else, so I never mentioned it. So that's why they ask you so many questions. So yes, if there's any more questions, feel free to hit them out. I might do a, like I said, I might do a video about this, like a proper one, so people could just watch and go back at like the end of the month or something, when I've gone through the whole process, because there's still like another process I need to do. But the main bit that asks you to write down the tax and the blah blah blah, I've done that bit now, thank God. Long, but yeah, I just thought, why not explain the stuff? And also, if you can explain something to somebody else, that means you really understand it. So I thought, if I can explain this to other people who don't get it, then that means I've probably understood it in well enough, rather than acting like, yeah, I think I know, but I don't really know. But yeah, anyway, thank you for listening. It's been a cute little 27 minutes, 22, 25, bow. Okay, cool. I will send UK Music TV. Hi. Yes, I will. Right. Okay, I will do another video. Basically explaining this without, so you can stop and play when you want. So you get it, because I just think that's important. And more to the point, think about your unborn children, because I'm sure you want to have children to pass down through the legacy what it is that you have. But if you don't set these things up, it literally makes it so hard for them to figure out what it is they need to do. Like, the last thing you want is to see your unborn children like a big pile of debt when you've just died, and you haven't given them no inkling, no help as to where the debt's coming, how much the debt is, how big the debt is, how long it's going on for, how many places you owe money to. Nothing worse than just not being knowledged. So yeah, anyway, I'm gonna love you and leave you. I'm gonna choreograph now. And yeah, front room feelings, bitch. Like, I kind of created a front room feelings so I could also have talks like this. Do you know what I mean? Bow. Do you know what I mean? Because, like, it's not every minute dance. Sometimes, like, you know, let's talk. Sometimes talk about life. Like, sometimes enhance yourself. Sometimes get more knowledge. Do you know what I mean? Because the government don't want to tell us nothing. 40% is a lot of money. Like, what? 40% of what? Like, what have you done for me that I must give you 40%? So if you could decrease that by actually knowing what it is that they're asking for, that's what I'm going to do. And I would say the best part of you explaining your assets is your personal belongings. Okay? So fill that out how you please, but that's the part that you have discretion over. Okay? So, yeah. Anyway, hey Jane. So yeah, anyways guys, if there's anything else you'd like really like me to talk about, if there's any topics you want me to really discuss about the death or whatever, in terms of, oh yeah, quick touch on the note, when somebody dies you have to get a death certificate and you have to get a green form. You also have to call up this other number and get that green form from the doctors to basically say, or the person who, what is it, the coroner, basically. You have to get it from the coroner, or you have to call up the person, the council that you live in, you have to call them and register the death. Then you have to have another appointment where they register the death, and then you can kind of have the funeral. If you don't do that within 2 weeks, they come for you. So yeah, a lot of stuff about death, but people just don't like talking about it. But I just think, you know, death is going to happen. It happens to all of us. We're all going to die. So if we could just be a bit more knowledgeable about that process, we can be less scared about it and just be like, yeah, it's cool, got it together. Wow. Wow. So yeah, guys, have a great day. Okay, I'm going to choreograph now. And wills and life insurance. Yeah, auntie, wills and life insurance is the way to go. Or gift your shit. Like, gift it away. Give it away, give it away, give it away. If you're dying, you don't need it, so give it away. Anyway, big love, guys. Mrs. Dempsey, Terry, hi. I'm going to do, like, a video on YouTube and post it. So if you missed the live, no worries. I will post the video. But it won't be, like, tomorrow. It'll be, like, towards the end of the month or whatever. But, yes, anyway, have a great day, and I see you soon. Thank you for watching. Big love. Bye-bye.